5 years ago, state lawmakers passed legislation to reform Arizona's adult probation system. The Safe Communities Act was designed to reduce the number of probationers that return to prison. Here to tell us more about the program and if it's meeting its goals is Kathy Waters, director of the Adult Probation Services Division of the Arizona Supreme Court, and state schools chief John Hoopenthal, who, as chairman of the state Senate Judiciary Committee, sponsored the probation reform legislation we're talking about today. Good to see you both here. Thanks for joining us.
It's great to be here.
Thank you.
The problem of probation failures in Arizona, how serious was it? What was addressed?
It was more serious than we would want it to be. Our success rate on standard probation was probably around a 60% success rate. Our most serious offenders, the IPS, our intensive probation, was even less than 50% of those were being successful on probation. And so we wanted to address what could we do to help people be more successful under probation supervision.
Were those numbers historically at that level? Were they increasing?
We were continually to see the, especially the more serious offenders.
Yes. Okay, so with that in mind, changing the system, what did you look at?
Well, at first I got this report from the Pew Foundation. I crumpled it up and threw it in the garbage can. And because I had the impression of them as a liberal outfit, and my assistant literally retrieved it from the garbage can and we went over it. But the thing that caught me was the setting of very high standards, being drug-free, being current on restitution, and being absolutely current on community service. And so by establishing that very high standard that you had to be 100% drug-free, current in restitution, and community service, it seemed to me that you would establish this high standard of conduct, and by continuing that month after month, that you could change their whole way of thinking, their whole way of life, and get greater success. And so then I sponsored the bill.
But weren't incentives involved here as well? I mean, it's one thing to say do this, it's another way thing to kind of push and get the carrot out in front.
For every month that they were 100% restitution, community service, drug-free, they got a month reduced on probation. And when I looked at this, I found out that almost all the failures, almost 100% of the failures occur in the first one-third of probation. So I thought, well, heck, we're giving something that has no value at the tail end of probation and it's achieving something that has great value at the beginning. And I thought, wow, this is a home run. We want to do this.
Did that idea, when it came down, did it make sense?
Yes, because at the same time, we were training our probation officers based on research, what we call evidence-based practices. And so we were using a validated risk assessment to really determine the high, medium, and low risk offenders and who we needed to focus on and put our resources towards that helped them to be more successful while on probation. And by doing that, and then also using the other principles of evidence-based practice with the treatment and helping to establish programs that help change their behavior, helping them be pro-social and productive citizens, it mirrored and it fell very well into the incentive-based of the Safe Communities Act.
Well, I think, you know, the policy is one thing, but if you don't have execution, and the courts have done a great job of executing, connecting probationers to church, connecting them to job, and connecting them to their families in a way that works, and getting them to stay out of triggers for drug abuse, and then training them on values. Most of these probationers have been in families where they've had a respected adults tell them that it's okay to steal, it's okay to commit violence. So now you have another adult who comes in a trained way and says it's not okay to steal, it's against the law, it's a moral violation, and it's not okay to commit violence. And the techniques that they execute are having results. So we're talking 1,200 reduced felonies, 1,200. That's 1,200 fewer murders, rapes, robberies. This is incredible, and at a lower cost, not a higher cost, to taxpayers.
We saw real significant differences very quickly. Chief Justice Ruth McGregor had spoken to the legislature and when we started using evidence-based practice as well, and said, we will attempt to reduce the revocations to prison and reduce new felonies by persons on probation. And she said, we'll try at least to hit 5% in that first year. Well, you can see by our numbers, the first year we're well over 12%. Mm-hmm. And it's continued to build, the success built, as we trained our probation officers to use these techniques to really put our resources on the right offenders and help them to become proactive based on other performance incentives as well, positive reinforcement to them as well. throughout.
And the performance incentives, I want to get back to that as well, because there's incentives for the probationers with time off of complying with conditions and these sorts of things, but the departments as well, correct me if I'm wrong, they were offered part of the budget savings mm-hmm. if they could show results.
They were, and it was an offer that was made, and being a part of the legislature, I have some guilt because it was an offer reneged on that once they achieved the performance, they didn't get the money.
Oh.
And so that has consequences to the whole feedback loop. But the thing the legislature needs to be aware of is these reduced revocations back to prison, that's $120 million a year less expense in the prison system. Our prison system is costing us in the neighborhood of $40,000 a year per inmate. This was 1,200 fewer inmates going into the system, so it's a huge.
That's interesting. So that particular incentive didn't make it through, huh?
No, it was a little bit of a. But the whole budget environment. There were a lot of things that didn't make it through in the budget process.
And I think, if anything, we established tremendous credibility not only in Arizona with what probation was doing. Our juvenile departments are now modeling some of the same practices as far as evidence-based practice. We get calls from all over the country saying these numbers cannot be real.
Well, let's talk about these numbers real quickly. 42% drop in revocations from 08 to 12. Revocations to prison down 44%. Revocations to jail down 12%. As far as a decrease in new felony convictions, down for the first 3 years. Do we know why fiscal year 11 there was an increase? Is there any reason for that? Is that just a...
I was just worried about the legislature not falling through on its promise, and there was a little bit of a letdown by people. But I think also there's no policy that's going to be a straight downward slide. It's not. So it's well within, it's still, at the terminal year, it's still over a 40% reduction, still at the terminal year, 1,200 fewer felonies.
And what the research says, why we were so excited, that when I go out and do the training, not only for probation departments, but for the judges and the prosecutors and public defenders, and we've really blitzed the state with all of our training of what evidence-based practices are and the results that you can get, it was obvious that it was a very big culture change in how we did business. So our numbers were better. We started seeing immediate results. And the bigger part of that, I think, is you have safer communities because of those 1,200 less felonies by persons on probation. They're successful, but you have that many less victims.
But was there pushback initially on that culture change at all?
It was a war getting this through the legislature.
Well, the legislature, yeah, but what about the other aspects of the probation community, if you will?
No, it really was. We had full support of the 15 chief probation officers across the state of Arizona, and they were all on board. They knew what the research said, and they knew that based on the research, we could get these results. But it was training. It was changing the way we did business. And it has been successful. When we started seeing the results, they spoke for themselves.
And what's the deal with the legislature? What happened there?
There's just a sense that anytime you're reducing anything, you're being soft on crime. So what we were doing is reducing the length of probation, but we were doing it for perfect behavior, drug-free, community service, restitution. And that's what I was able to use as a hammer, is that we know that this is going to reduce crime, protect families. And we were making a prediction based on John Huppenthal saying this is good policy. And that's why this is important, too, that we let people know that my prediction was correct, that we and the probation department's prediction was correct, that you can do complex policy and get great results for families.
So what do we take from this report, and where does adult probation in Arizona go from here?
We continue to refine and make sure that we have the same success, that we continue to implement our evidence-based practices, using our assessment, targeting the right offenders, developing the programs, the treatment programs, and instilling the right programs that really address their issues is very, very important. So we're working on that program development continually.
Well, I think not only in this case, but now we think the legislature needs to be thinking about a number of policies in a more complex fashion. Through policy, we were able to save many tens of millions of dollars, many lives. What they need to be thinking about in other areas are prisons. That 15%, mm-hmm. they need to be thinking about that in terms of the standards they apply by which somebody reduces a prison sentence, and thinking about there's a whole lot that we know now in the research about prison that we can use policies like this to do great things for society in that area too.
Okay, we got to stop it right there. Good to have you both here. Thanks for joining us.
Thank
we appreciate
so
it.
Much.